in black. Good guys sometimes make mistakes. I say, don't look back. Be mindful how you get used up. You get away. Trust an honest man.
You following me? Where do we go now?
Welcome to Sandkits.
It's nice to be here.
Tell me, what sense of feeling do you have to know you're coming home to the nation, to the island, the land of your birth?
You're becoming
a full independent nation on September 19th, next week, Monday. How do you feel?
I feel very excited. I was really, somebody asked me today when I was coming, you know, does it feel as if you're coming home? And I said no, but I was lying because when I was coming over, just as we saw the island, I got really excited.
It's great.
It looks very different.
Okay.
You know, when we went to Antigua, it looks more sort of, I don't know, I like it here.
Okay. Joan, thank you very much for talking to us.
Yes.
Have a nice day.
Thank you.
Joan Armatrading, well-known star from St. Kitts, and now home for independent celebrations. For the rest of the time, they should be here. We hope that we see much of her and hear much about her as well.
And thank you for the music.
You haven't been here in St. Kitts since you were a tot.
Since I was three.
Since you were three.
Yes, and my parents decided they'd had enough. I don't know why, it's really nice.
Do you have a sense of you can understand that you came from here?
Oh, I understand that I came from here, yes. I've always been curious. I've never been sort of curious to the point of sort of rushing to history books or asking my parents lots and lots of questions about the islands or trying to sort of conjure up my whole sort of roots and stuff like that. But I've always wanted to see the place where I was born, if not the house, just the island. Are you laughing at? Hello? Is this where the Billinghurst used to live?
Yeah.
Can I come up and have a look?
Yes.
I've come to ask if I can look around your house, because this is supposed to be where I was born. Is that all right? Thanks very much. Okay, so she can show me, can she? Okay. Here we go then. You better talk me through it. What room's this? What room's this? The sitting room.
Yeah, the front room.
Okay, where are we going?
Bedroom.
This is the bedroom. Do you know if this has always been the bedroom?
Yeah.
Yeah? Cool. But is there another bedroom?
Yeah.
Another one. Oh, yeah. So I could have been born in this room. Found the house and we went into it and there's two bedrooms and I'm trying to figure out...
Hello?
One of these rooms I was born in, one of these rooms was... where it was all sort of worked.
Tisha.
Oh no, look at this. This is me when I was born. I'm about a month old. Happy little soul. Hey? She's great. It's a strange sort of feeling. It's It's trying desperately to remember. There's no way you're going to remember, you know.
Yes.
And I have no memories of the island at all. Like, my mom will tell me of sort of being with my grandmother and running down the street, and they do sort of shaved ice here, and they call it Fraco. And she tells me of me running down the street shouting for the guy who does this shaved ice and stuff like that, which I really wish I could remember. Because my parents are not, to me, the typical West Indian, you know. First of all, when they got to where they were, whether by design or accident, they didn't go to a black community. They didn't sort of get to Birmingham and suddenly sort of move into Handsworth, which was the black area, or move into the other black area. So they didn't seem to me that they were trying to keep any real ties to the West Indies. Although they talk about it very fondly, they're very aware of where they're from. They're very proud of where they're from. But they're also very aware that they're in England. They're very conscious that is what's, you know, giving them a better sort of way of life and the whole thing. And so I've grown up very, very much in England, even though I went there at 7, which I suppose it is very young to really remember the West Indies.
Well, since, as you say, you weren't brought up in England with the consciousness of being West Indian all around you, then I suppose the answer to the question, where did you come from musically, would be that you just picked up bits and pieces and put them together.
Well, there would be lots of bits and pieces. I would have listened to the radio then, I would imagine, pretty much the way I listen to it now, not trying to be... I don't want to imitate anybody, but I like to listen to everybody because I like all the different sorts of music, and I like to listen to people that I think are good. I also like to listen to people that I think are bad to see what's happening, you know.
But also at that age, maybe you didn't control the radio dial anyway.
No, but I would listen in the way that I listen, that not because I wanted to copy it, you know. I don't remember being one of the kids who went in front of the mirror with the guitar and sort of practiced.
Thank you. myself promotion. I want myself a great big star. I'm not so certain I won't make that star a crown. Well, I'm free and I'm alone with me. Step on now, right out of commotion. Stepping into life, stepping into life again. Stepping now, stepping now, stepping now.
Join him.
That's right.
And he was a nice man.
You think he was nice?
Oh, yes, because as far as I understand that, as far as I know that, because he walks to me. He also walks to me.
Were you a carpenter as well?
Yes, right.
Yeah. Do you know his brother?
His brother was taller than him.
Yeah, he was.
One was.
He was fatter than him, I know that.
Both of them. Of our rent to England.
That's right.
Well, I didn't hear nothing at all again.
Did you say that my father gave you some sort of stone, was it? Was it?
Yeah. This is his.
He gave you this. This is all he ever gave you, is
it?
Yeah, that's my father.
And that is what I keep as a souvenir.
Oh, yeah.
And a set stone.
Yeah. That's really good. So he probably wants it back. I'll have to take it back for him now.
No, right? I won't be able to give it back now. Because this here is my
Did he was supposed to be a bass player. Do you know that part?
Yes, he used to play football. He used to play football.
Was it? What about
the baseball?
No, not a baseball, a musician. Was he a musician?
Oh, yes, yes, yes.
Do you remember what he played?
He played what? Cornet.
Did he?
Things like that.
I don't know. I know he plays the trumpet now, but I don't know whether he did it while he was in the West Indies.
Now, where does your dad fit in this musically? Because he did play the guitar, didn't he?
Yeah, he played the guitar. He was supposed to be a musician here, and the one guy that I spoke to couldn't remember him being a bass player, because according to my mom, most of my information is from my mom. According to her, he was a bass player, a double bass player on the island in a band. Well, this one of the guys said he was in the band, but he said he played one of the drums. So I don't know. He played the guitar, and that's it could be from maybe seeing him play the guitar that made me want to. I know people are surprised when I don't sort of, when they say who do you like, and I don't rattle off a whole ream of black soul artists, you know. You shouldn't have to like a certain thing just because you're it or there or yes. whatever.
Yes. I think people are a lot of times surprised also that you don't do more reggae type tunes or something like that. They'd almost like to be able to typecast you.
Yes. I suppose I'd probably do more if, I mean, I like it and I'd like to do more, but I also like to hear it done really well. You know, and I don't think I'm the best sort of reggae artist.
No, I've been saying there's something I have to prove. Keep on going, baby. There's no stop now. I'm about to lose. To the limit, here we go. From the bottom to the top. Gonna tell all of my friends. Say I can run and then they try. Some move more quickly and know they can stand the pace. Others were sober thinking they're just the same. I know I went first and not just a place. Keep on pushing, baby. From the bottom to the top. Gonna tell all of my friends. Say I can rest on that try. Some move more quickly and know they can stand the pace. Others more sober thinking they're just the same. I know I want first and not just a place. Keep on pushing, baby.
Had a chance to hear at night some of the music being played locally because with the celebrations going on, they've been going well into the night, as anyone who's tried to fall asleep early can attest.
Yeah.
Can you sense any type of musical influence there that was subconscious on you?
No, because the music that they've been playing, it's been great music, but I don't know if it's this island's music. I think it's more Jamaican music. Mm-hmm. They've been playing lots of reggae, and it's that dubbed reggae. Mm-hmm. They've played calypso music, where we went to this calypso thing, and that was really interesting. But it's the sort of calypso that I heard in Antigua, so I don't really know whether it's a music that's sort of all the islands, or if they all have their own identity, do you know?
I don't
really know what I was listening to. I mean, I loved it. I thought it was great.
It's a joy for any nation to attain its independence, and an equal joy to be able to guide one's future existence. So it is no surprise to me, we having big, big celebration. I only hope we don't forget the serious implications.
So there was one band that we listened to that had the brass section where everybody was just out of tune, just enough with each other. You know the one? Brilliant. And so the bass guy's in sort of whatever he's in, and the keyboard player. And the keyboard player is not only out of tune with the bass player and the rest of the horn section, but he's out of tune with himself. So it's just, it should sound horrible, but it sounds brilliant.
There are those who oppose this move we're about to make. They insist that we're ill-prepared and that we're making a big mistake. They don't like those who hold the reins of power in our state and swear that in our celebrations they won't participate. Our country stands divided, so how can we move ahead? What we really need is unity as we achieve full sovereignty. Our independence should mean cooperation, working together for the betterment of our nation. And no matter who becomes our nation's prime minister, let's all strive.
It's really nice. I like it a lot. Nice people. Lots of innocence. They have a lot of sort of morals that I find very confusing. I mean, you know, they like to sort of mess about. But even so, they have this innocence still, you know, where you can walk the streets at night and you can go up and you can talk to anybody. Like I was the other day when I was walking around, there were some rough guys who, they were all this sort of big sort of macho thing, and they were shouting at each other and swearing and doing the whole business. And I thought, oh God, well, okay, you had to find them, right? There they are. They came walking down and they saw me and they sort of went, oh, Miss Armatrading, oh, it's really nice to meet you. This whole thing changed, you know, it was suddenly this whole, you wouldn't get that sort of in England, you know. You have more money, you can probably live in a much nicer house, but then you lose another side of it, you know. You lose this freshness, this friendliness, this sort of trust. People would have a better standard of living, I think. They'd probably have much more independence, I think in England than here. Because I think here you have to rely on lots of other people, and the guys who don't work get looked after by their families or their friends. And that's nice. Well, you can't do that in England. In England, you don't work. You go to the dole, or if you're really down and out, you're down and out, and you're on the streets, and nobody would say hello to you.
Some people wanna see my blood gush out, and others wanna watch while I crawl. I heard somebody say once I was way too flat, and someone else is cheating.
Where I say, some people say she's too black, some people say she's not black enough. No, that was just sort of, it's just a song about, there's nothing you can, anything you do for some people will never be right. Whichever way you go, it's sort of like they wait for you to turn in a direction so they can say you're wrong, you know. That's what that was about, not really sort of, It was really thinking about people saying, oh, you know, why don't you write black music? And then other people saying, you shouldn't write black music or whatever, you know.
Of course, that's almost outside your brief anyway, isn't it?
To write black music? Well, I am black, and I write music. So to me, it's black music.
You step lightly thinking you're number one. Down a zero with a word, leaving for another one. Now you walk with your feet back on the ground. Down to the ground, down to the ground. Down to the ground, down to the ground. Walks through the crowd and takes your man, sends you rushing to the mirror.
A lot of people think that your songs tell the story of their life, don't they? Have you had people come up and say that?
Yes, all the time, and they're right, really. It is their lives. I mean, I've written songs that have got nothing to do with me, and then maybe years later, you know, something will happen to me and I'll be able to refer to a song that I've written, you know, before that I thought would never relate to me, and it does.
You know how it is, still more crying when you're thinking of your mother's only son. Take to your bed, you sit this peace and sleep, but you dream of love instead. All the heartache you'll find can bring more pain than a blister in song. But oh, when you fall, oh, when you fall, you fall at my door. The ground, down to the ground, down to the ground. You're no hiding, still more crying when you're thinking of your mother's only son. Took to your bed, you set this piece in sleep, but you dream of love instead. But oh,
recording artist for over a decade. Mm. And yet you've never been controversial, if you see what I mean. Most artists manage to somehow put their foot in it some way along the line. Are you shrewd or are you naive?
Probably naive. I'm not shrewd. I'm not really trying not to be controversial. Just sort of trying to be myself. I stay pretty much by myself, you know. I'm not a big socializer, never have been. I think that's some of the reasons that people sort of get into the gossip columns, because they socialize a lot, they go out to lots of different places, and I don't do that out of habit and out of, I don't know, I'm not really curious to go to a lot of the places that you can get your face in the paper all the time. I don't like to be with lots of crowds. Or...
people to the left of me, people to the right. I want to be alone. But it just gets worse all the time.
can't make it work. People all around me in love and pain. Some are integrated, driving me insane. They thought I'd cut me right out of my head. Scheming, there's people cheating. Pressure from all sides. Train you, they'll try to train you. There's no escaping people.
Your first time back in St. Kitts?
First time since I was 3, yeah. Three.
What are some of your feelings and thoughts, you know, coming back here, first of all, for the independence, and second of all, coming back as a celebrity?
It's been a really sort of strange experience, just walking around, just trying to visualize, you know, I wonder if I've walked down this street before, or... like I went the other day to have a look at the house where I was born, and there's two bedrooms, and I don't know which of the rooms I was supposed to have been born in, so I was sort of standing in each one trying to see if I could sort of conjure up some sort of memory, which was impossible. I join in much more these days than I say for the last, I don't know, 3-4 years, say, maybe 5 years, I've been getting more and more involved with things. I'll join in conversations now, and I'll answer questions. But before I wouldn't. I'd be yes or no to anybody, not just an interviewer, but to people, general. That'd be something, it'd be yes or no or nothing. And I'd just sit and look.
Remember when you took me to some party with your arm around my waist?
More confidence. I feel confident because I know there are a lot of people who like what I'm doing. I don't always feel confident that people like me, because I don't always know. When somebody says they like me, what do they mean me? I always figure that they're talking about what I do. They don't qualify it. You know, they don't say, Joan, I like you. Or do they want to be friends because they've got one of your records?
Things can change, there's always changes. And I want to try some rearranging. I say, drop the pilot, try my balloon. Drop the monkey, smile my. Don't use
do reach a wider audience, you find yourself being asked to do things that you might not have foreseen or wanted to do. Do you find demands on your time like that an irritant, or can you understand it?
I understand it. I understand it very well. But some things are irritable because they're just not really practical things. You know, I mean, somebody might ask you to come to their party to sing.
Drop the pilot, try my balloon. Drop the monkey, smile my buffoon. Drop the mahoo, I need a rider. Don't use your army to fight a losing battle. Drop the pilot,
then you get asked to lots of charity things. Well, you have to, at a point, you have to know to say, I'm sorry, I can't do this, because you would end up being a charity. And if you did everything that people asked you, that's all the time you'd have. You know, you'd be constantly doing this thing. You sort of have to try and work out what you can do.
I went on another ship once. I don't remember, it was a long time ago, when I was young, when I was younger, and I was about to be trapped in a sailor's cabin, I remember that much.
Experience you've remembered ever
since. Hello.
Gentlemen, can I introduce Joan to you? Now, this is typical of a sailor's mess deck, and these are typical sailor's chaps.
Yes.
Yeah. But where do you sleep? Everybody sleeps in there.
That's it.
In the one bed?
Three beds there.
Oh, I see.
How many is in this mess, chaps?
25.
25. And this is considered one of the smaller, more comfortable messes.
Do you get on?
Would I ask you to sign up this?
Yeah, sure.
It's not for me, it's for his brother.
No, it's for me, actually.
It's supposed to be for his aunt.
I would have been very happy if I'd made my records and remained anonymous. But that's not how it was, so this I accept, that you go out and people will say hello. And I like it. I like them to say hello. I like them to come up and say they like the songs, and they come up and say they hate the songs. They come up and say anything. It's almost part of the job.
Oh, yeah. The crest is, we'll shake hands because it's official, it's in the Navy. The crest is of a black bear chained to a tree, which is in fact the crest of the town of Berwick-on-Tweed, which is in north of England. And we are the 10th ship to bear that crest. We're very proud of it. It's nice to be accepted.
That's lovely. I'm very happy to accept it and put it on my wall as soon as I get home.
And I thank you for coming on board.
Oh, I've enjoyed it. Yes, I've enjoyed it. It's been great. And I'd like to join up.
You'd like to join up, yes. Any time, Joan, any time.
I have a responsibility. I don't feel as if I have to go out and spread the gospel of St. Kitts, but I will. Now I can say more because I've been here. Before, all I could say was I was born there. I didn't know anything about it. It's a really nice place, but I don't feel I'm sort of obligated now that I was invited to the ceremonies. And I don't think they don't really owe me anything. It's the same thing. I was born here, but I haven't been here sort of working the land and really sort of putting all my efforts into St. Kitts, you know. I think I've sort of brought it to a few people's notice because I was born here.
After sell-out concert tours across the world and millions of record sales, they're still describing singer Joan Armatrading as shy, private, even difficult. Well, it is true that the enigmatic Miss Armatrading likes to do a Greta Garbo every now and then. Off stage, she usually prefers to be alone. We discovered a very different Joan when we went on tour with her in America recently, just before she packed her bags to come here to see her Australian fans. She may have come out of the closet as a star, but privacy and simplicity are still Joan Armatrading's priorities. this opportunity to observe close up. The singer-songwriter at work in the sanctuary of her Boston hotel room is rare to say the least.
Came into my life, made me think that I was really something.
Love and hate in personal relationships are this woman's themes, but she insists they're not taken from her own life.
Somebody can't write 27 albums just about themselves. I don't think anybody's that interesting, you know.
You insist that you don't write about yourself in your songs, that they're not autobiographical, but surely your own attitudes and values must come through in your lyrics.
Oh, yes, I think so. I do say, I can't swim, but I like the sea, which is me. I can't swim, but I love the sea. And I say, I'm brown enough. In fact, I'm overdone, turn me over. Well, that's me. Anybody can say, take that song to be for them. Because I've had guys come up to me and say, oh, Joan, you just expressed that feeling for me perfectly in a song. And a girl come up and say exactly the same thing about exactly the same song. And I had one couple who used to write their love letters were my lyrics back and forth. So it obviously worked for both of them.
You were the go-between.
I was it. And that's, yeah, I was really flattered.
You guys ready?
Joan was born in St. Kitts in the Caribbean, but 33 years later, she's more British Midlands than West Indian. She grew up in Birmingham. Not that she's there all that much these days.
This is chamomile tea here.
Here, she's on tour, backstage in Boston, where self-imposed domestic chores keep Miss A in touch with the real world.
You sort of do it and just forget everything else while you're doing it.
Has it got anything to do with helping you feel vaguely normal? When you're on the road, I mean, it's...
Oh, yeah, you definitely feel normal when you're ironing.
There's nothing more normal than ironing.
This is as normal as you can get.
Do you regard yourself as a feminist?
I suppose I am, in as much as I believe in equality. I do believe that women should be given the chance to do stuff that the guys can do, if they can do it.
Joan Armatrading's audiences, even in black heavy places like Boston, are overwhelmingly white. She admits that despite her background, there's very little about her that's black, strangely enough, including her music.
People even say I do reggae like a white guy.
So about the only black element in your music are
is
in
this?
Fact... Precisely. So is the whole question of race important to you?
Is it? Well, yes, it is important, but there's black guys that you don't like, there's black guys that you like, there's white guys you don't like, white guys you like. It's, in the end, it should be people that you get on with or don't. All the way from
America. Literally on the road again. This time from polite Boston to make or break New York, the town that could send Joan over the top into superstardom.
And he said Ronnie Reagan will make a great president because Americans grow up wanting to be a cowboy, a movie star, or the president. In him, they've got all three.
So far, it's been so good with the American leg of this 1983 world tour. New York's not about to become the exception. The concert there is already a sellout. All the pre-publicity about Joan Armatrading is such that you'd have to approach a profile like this with a fair degree of trepidation. We're told she's not only shy, she's tense, difficult, and wary of strangers.
I am shy. If it's somebody I've got to meet more than once, I tend to be shy. Like, these days, I find that I have to put people at ease rather than the other way around.
Because they're a little overawed, maybe?
Whatever the reason, maybe, I don't know that they're overawed, but they know the face more than I know their face.
Up until now, her international following has been that of a cult singer rather than a pop idol. But cult singer, rock star, or superstar, Joan Armatrading remains a quiet, admirably unassuming woman. Through it all, just Joan.
Don't you come on so strong.
Sydney.
But I'm up to persuasion. He stole it, I stole it. For romance with a friend, I can smile. But with a lover, I could hold my head back. I could really laugh, really laugh. Cross the floor, cheek to cheek. But with a lover, I could really move, really move. I could really dance, really dance, really dance, really dance. I could really move, really move, really move, really move. Now if I could feel a song in my eyes, in the rain on my face, why can't I feel love? I can really love, really love, really love, really love, really love, 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 love. Now I got I may need more, but I should just stick to those that I have done. With friends I still feel so insecure. And darling, I believe you could help me love. Just take my hand and lead me away, away. Once more. We'll be right back.
attempt this little number, What I Wrote.
Ah!
come by the score. If you've got something missing, I'll help you look, you can be sure. And if it's money you want, trouble has, whatever you want me to, all you gotta do is ask. Thunder, don't go under the sheet. Lightning on the tree. In the rain, snow, I'll be outside. Come running to me when things get out of hand. Running to me when it's more than you can stand. I said I'm strong. When the sun is out.
very much. Good night.